My name is Gustavo Victor Goler, and I'm an art conservator and a carver, a contemporary sculptor. I work specifically with religious artwork, mainly saints in particular. As far as the restoration and the conservation goes, I specialize in the older New Mexico santos and the history of the New Mexico saint maker. And as a contemporary saint maker, I carve my own pieces that represent a growth and a progression from the older historical New Mexico saints. This particular project was presented to me by a client that I have, an individual that's interested actually in the growth and the progression of the New Mexico saint maker. And so he presented this project to me that would represent a little bit some of the directions that I'm taking with my work. This piece will really represent a challenge to me. It's a piece that will be challenging in a few different areas, certainly in the design area, in the complexity of the theme, and also the complexity of the carving involved. Those were some of the requirements of this particular client. So we're working with a little bit larger size than I'm used to working with. We're putting together a very sort of dynamic design that has a lot of movement. But the whole idea is to get this sense of movement as this piece sort of rises, and that's where the complexity of the carving comes in and some of the structural aspects behind it. It also has a lot of iconography. This is the ascension of Christ, so he's represented with angels around him as he's being carried up to heaven, and at the foundation, at the base, we'll have the 12 apostles representing further iconography for that particular theme. The very beginning of this piece would be, of course, you know, picking the wood, you know, and then making sure that you have the proper tools or a woodworker that's going to help laminate the wood, that is, to put it together, where the seams, where your joinery has to be immaculate. Once it is carved and polished and sanded, you can imagine with a piece of size, you can add a tremendous amount of detail, and so all of that takes even more time and stuff. You just keep reducing and reducing. Once we do finally get to that point, it's hard to see the light at the moment, we go through a traditional process of gessoing the piece and sizing the piece. We'll mix some animal hide glue and we'll mix some gesso and do certain layers. What that does is it primes the piece so that it can be painted. Once that is dried, we sand it again, Then we start the painting procedure. The painting procedure, again, is also kind of something that's very time consuming, because the way that the application of color is that it takes 2 to 3 layers to create one color. So there's a lot of sort of layering, a lot of sort of glazes that go on top of the piece to finally get it done. Once the piece is finally painted, you know, then we go into sort of some glazes, some antiquing processes. Prior to the final varnish, usually takes 2 to 3 coats of varnish. After that, we try to use non-yellowing conservation varnish that has UV protectors and, you know, helps protect the piece down the line. Finish it off with a light wax. And then, voila, hundreds of hours later.